Hey everybody, my name is Justin. Welcome back to our BTR garage. Have you guys ever heard of 3D printing? If you haven't, it is a manufacturing process where you can make all kinds of different things in the world using a 3D based computer model. Everything from smartphone cases to utensil holders to medical equipment, even artificial organs, as crazy as that sounds, can be created with 3D printing. Now, in our use case, car parts, we're looking for 3D printed car parts, and I have my first 3D printed car component that we're going to be installing on the car. We're going to show you what we've got and then get it installed. The use cases for 3D printed car parts is almost endless, from door handles to headlights, taillights, mirrors, clips and clamps, fuel and brake plumbing fittings. It probably goes on and on. Now for my 2017 BRZ here, what I have is a pair of these little guys. Now, can anybody guess what these are just by looking at them? Probably not. They are actually compression canister mounts for my MCS suspension on the car here. What these will do is allow us to mount the canisters similar to the way they are mounted today on those upper strut braces on the car. It eliminates the need for the stock or other homemade type of canister mount that you might have. For me, I have the MCS specific mounts that use zip ties and the little metal brackets. These are much cleaner and better looking, in my opinion, and these come from a company called Rapid Design. They make these for the MCS canisters. I'm sure you can get them for other suspension canisters as well that have remote canisters like this. And it is a true 3D printed part. You can tell just by looking at it, the 3D printed layers all the way down the canister mount there. Very cool little parts. And what we're gonna do is remove the MCS kit that I have on there right now and then get these guys installed. There's a special little process to get these installed. You have to actually warm them up in some warm soapy water so they become a little bit more flexible. And then we'll install them onto the upper strut brace and then slide the canister through the large end of the hole. And that should be it. Removing the old MCS mount kit was pretty simple. I just clipped the big zip ties on there and set them aside and set the canister down to the wayside as well here. I had to clean up some of this old tape that I put on the brace in order to protect it from getting scratched and things. So we'll get that taken off as well and then clean up the residue on the bar left over by the tape. Next, we're gonna move the actual brace. Grab a small bowl of hot tap water with a little bit of soap in it, and then grab your 3D printed mount and drop it in there. We're gonna let that sit in there for about 5 or 6 minutes so it softens up and becomes pliable. You'll also notice I have a heat gun over here, or a hair dryer you can use as well to heat up the part once it's actually on the bar here to make it more pliable when we put the compression canister through the mounts. All right, once that has been sitting in the water for a little while, we'll take it out. And then you'll see I marked the brace with a little blue tape and with a mark on the end so I know which end is the inside. I'm gonna slide this over the flared end of this side of the bar, and this is the most tricky part of the process, but stuff is pretty flexible and pliable, and just kind of get it over the lip like that, and then you can press it over further. And it will go on slowly but surely. Once you get over the flared end there, it slides down the rest of the way pretty easily. And we'll go ahead and put the bar back into place. Put on just a couple of the nuts and bolts for the moment, just so I can orient the canister mounts. go. Get that in position. Remove our marking tape. And this is where we'll grab our heat gun and just heat up the larger part of the mount just a little bit. You don't want to get too hot. The instructions say don't go hotter than 300 degrees Fahrenheit, but just use the heat gun a little bit to get it more pliable. I'm gonna grab a little soap from the bucket that we had. Just put it in there, a little soapy water just to make it slide in a little bit smoother. Grab the canister, and then it's just a matter of getting it slipped through. And this is another one of the tricky parts of it. There we go, almost there. There we go. As you can see, once you get it over the initial hump on the canister, it slides pretty easily. And that mount, as it starts to cool off, it will shrink a little bit and then tighten up, but pretty much good there. We'll throw our other nuts back on to the brace here. Make sure they are snugged down. And after a bit of cooling off, these things are good to go. Nice and solid, don't move around. And I can actually adjust the compression knob without touching the canister. With the MCS kit, I actually had to hold the canister while twisting the knob because it would just move too much, but these are nice and solid. So there we go, everybody, 3D printed shock reservoir mounts for my Subaru BRZ from Rapid 3 Design. You can check them out at rapid3design.com. They also have a Facebook page, which I'll put the links down in the description below if you want to check them out and some of the other things they are 3D printing these days. So if you have any thoughts, comments, or questions on my first ever 3D printed part for my car, leave them down below. I'd love to hear from you. Stick around for more good stuff coming up here real soon. Stay fast out there. I am checking out. We'll talk to you all next time.